It's your favorite news and current affairs program reaching you live from TVC News here in our headquarters, Lagos, Nigeria. And I still have Babajide Kolade Otitoju and Adekunle Yusuf here with me. Hard times are here, and government is also feeling the heat. The federal government has raised the alarm that the country's debt profile will keep rising as it will continue to borrow more to fund the 2022 budgets. It says it will also spend more to service the growing debts. As such, Nigeria's debt stock will keep rising as revenues are declining. As of the last count, we've incurred over 20 trillion naira. What? Both internal and external debts. And the way we projected 2021, the budget, I immediately saw it. I knew that funding was going to be the main challenge. Now, ahead of 2022 now, you don't need any soothsayer to tell you that paying our existing debt and even borrow more to finance this budget, whatever we borrowed in 2021, I know that it's going to be doubled for 2022.
You know, I've talked about this before, and I said in the post-COVID era, all countries are adjusting their budgets to current realities. In our own case, we are increasing the size of the budget year on year, not caring whether we can meet revenue projections or not. Ordinarily, because of what we went through with COVID, because of what the global community went through with COVID, the size, the budget, the 2021 budget size shouldn't be that big. You try to shrink the size of your budget in line with realities, because revenues are shrinking everywhere. It's not a Nigerian problem alone. The problems that COVID caused all oil-producing nations so far from it. So people decided, okay, let's not shrink our budget. Even look at the clubs, for example. The reality, the football clubs, the reality is they can't make the kind of money they were making before.
Look at what happened to Barcelona.
People want to sell, yes. Yeah. People want to sell players, but the buyers are not there.
Even offer to cut 50% of his salary.
Yes, because clubs are slashing budget. So in our own case, for reasons best known to us, we just went, okay, even this 2021, this should be the size of the budget. When you knew that you will not be able to find the money to fund the budget. Now, the unfortunate thing is every year, we're already talking about 2022, that we are going to get loans to fund the budget. The question for me, Ayo, is when are we going to stop borrowing money to fund the budget? When? Because when you are told that, oh, this borrowing is for capital expenditure, we want to fund projects, big projects. But that is not true. Part of the money that we are, the loans that we are taking, we are using to pay loans that were already there. And if you read the finance minister properly, go through what she said, and I don't blame her because she has to be open.
She has to open up
because she's facing the international community. People, we want to take more loans. People will ask questions and all that. She's already telling us that capital expenditure will suffer. What does that tell you? That should tell you that, look,
structure.
Because normally it is capital projects that benefit the ordinary man. The current expenditure benefits the civil servants who wants to steal.
Government bureaucracies.
Yes, that's what I mean by the civil servant who wants to steal. It's the capital projects benefit the ordinary folk, folks. But she has already told us, if you read between the lines, that capital expenditure will come down. That is what Nigerians don't want to see. Because if we are taking loans to build projects, yes, we agree. Now, if part of these loans will go to servicing debt, That means we are digging ourselves into a hole that we may not be able to come out of it easily. And the question is, when does that stop? Are we going to stop by the by 2025 budget to stop taking loans to fund the budget? When are we going to stop? The only way to do it is to limit your expectations, shrink your projections. These projections we know will not just work. Go back to the projections about the 2021 budget. We can see clearly that they are not working. It didn't work the previous year. It's not working for 2021 because the revenue is simply not coming in. Investors are not coming in. Who wants to invest in a country with insecurity and all that? And where are you going to find the money? And you must fund the budget. And you must pay the debt, and the debts in any case are denominated in foreign currency. Mm. You must pay them. So we've got to come up with the right strategy. What is the CBN doing, for example? Today, banks have been told that they should be in charge of sales. Not a bad idea, given that the Bureau de Change operators were into money laundering and the rest of that. But we are also dashing money to banks. Because if you peg the exchange rate at 410, and you know that the parallel market is 510, you are just dashing people 100 naira for not doing anything. We are just that. Now banks, instead of lending to the real sector, which is the engine of growth, the banks will now save their money for foreign exchange transactions. That's where the banks will be spending their money now. Who will be interested in lending? When you can spend money on Forex?
This is difficult to comprehend. That we are going to have a deficit budget again, that we are going to have a budget that we don't have funds to finance.
It's really sad because when you look at it, over the years, the trend is the same. When you look at 2019, Nigeria made 3.8 trillion total revenue for the country, but it spent 2.11 trillion to service loans. That's their record. This is not opinion of anybody, which is 54.6% of the total revenue went into. But I mean, service. That is, but you have to pay interest on those loans. Now,
I want to keep going.
Last year, Nigeria made a total of 3.2 trillion. Throughout last year, but we spent 2.3 trillion to service our debts, which is 72% of our total, earnings. So, which means that we got worse from 54% in 2019, we went lower to 72%. That is to say, people don't understand, it means that out of 100 naira Nigeria mix, more than 70 naira will go into servicing interest on debts that we have. So what we are seeing is Nigeria is underperforming in revenue generation. When you look at Nigeria very well, when it comes to revenue from non-oil sector, Nigeria is doing fantastically well. It's either they get the target or they even get above it. But when you go to oil revenue, Nigeria is a failure, abysmal failure in that aspect. But instead of Nigeria to sit down and realize what the enormity of the problem is, Nigeria keeps spending more than it earns. So as an individual, when you spend more money than your salary, what it means is it's either you go to GD or you come to me to borrow money because you have to make, you get what I'm, so that's what Nigeria is doing. So you will see, this is a country where you have problem of revenue shortages. But every day you see them, they are establishing new universities, they are spreading this, they are coming up with new institutes, they are coming with new commissions. So it means that you are expanding the recurrent revenue base of the, I mean, the current expenditure base of the government without a corresponding expansion in revenue generation. So what we are going to have is we continue to have more and more economic crisis. And I believe a government that is winding down like this one should think twice about this kind of issue.
Okay, I have Engineer Afolabi from Songota, Ogun State.
Yes. Okay. Thank you. Good evening.
Good evening, sir.
And Ayo, my other petitioner on the seat. Yes, I want to see Yoruba say Ayawo Sanwo Gbese Omo Ẹ O Le Tan. What I mean is that how can we be borrowing to pay debt? Number one. Then when we are having oil revenue and the oil is increasing internationally, that excess, where does it go? I think since we are operating on the template of the application of Abacha, I think it is up to that. When we are having more money at the international market, and we can the money at the remission.
Thank you.
The figures
are not looking good at all. Not looking good. I remember when Gozo Konjo-Wala, when we celebrated that debt relief, at that time, that we were able to pay the Paris Club $12 billion and that was forgiven. Now we both local and international debt were heavily indebted, and some people will tell you that yes, the administration is borrowing money to finance infrastructure that will last us years upon years and years. That they will employ people from the work, that well, they are constructing roads, they will employ Nigerians directly or indirectly, that it will just keep the whole thing running, that you have to borrow to save the economy.
The truth is, there are some projects that we shouldn't get involved in. Building 10 lanes to somewhere. There are some projects that will not repay themselves. Let me tell you, the Abuja Kaduna Rail Project, we've been operating it since 2015. We have not made profit. Yes.
Despite the fact that they have high...
We have not made profit. As of today.
Concentration of people.
We have not made profit.
It is not even commercially viable.
We've not made profit. Let me tell you, now you take loans to do those big projects. How do you pay back? How do you pay back? Those projects, the projects that that can repay themselves are the projects that we should go for. When we say we are taking loan for this infrastructure, for that infrastructure, if those projects can't repay themselves, then that means we took a bad decision in taking loans to start those projects. Mm. So that is the thing. No one is against infrastructure. Yes, we have infrastructure deficit that we must address. Mm. But what we need to do now is to do our best to improve our capacity to generate revenue. In the past, I have said that, look, when people say that a debt to GDP ratio, no, it cannot work in our case. We should be looking at debt to revenue ratio. If your capacity to bring in revenue is low, then how do you pay? That means the cycle of borrowing will not stop. And we have to stop at some point, because when you have already, we are being warned. I think Okonjo-Iweala and the Akinwumi of ADP, they warned us the other day.
Stylishly.
Yes. Which we were still told that, debt to GDP ratio of Nigeria. If you are talking about debt to GDP ratio, countries like Japan, yes, they can be talking about debt to GDP. But in our own case, the problem is we are not bringing in enough revenue. So it makes continuous borrowing unsustainable, and we have been warned. The earlier we take the warning, the better.
All right.